This creative idea about this movie was created by Marwan Al-Akbari and was directed by Yahya Hamidaddin. Under all of the circumstances and the conditions of war in Yemen, hopefully you'll like it. Gramstein by Grobe 8. Done by Rifat Muhammad Jalouk, Ridwan Al-Kipsi, Adnan Al-Mahmoudi, Yahya Hamidaddin, Marwan Al-Akbari, Hamza Rajah, Ali Karman, Osama Ashwaiter. Staining, one of the issues that face the histology scientist in the histology world. Staining simply means coloring of the microorganism within the day that emphasize and illustrate a different structure of the microorganism, including bacteria, virus, protozoa. There are many types of staining, like iron, hemotaxylene stain, and simple stain, and acid fast stain, and special stain. And also, our main object, the Gramstein, that we are going to talk about in our short movie. Gramstein is a common technique used to differentiate two large groups of bacteria based on their different cell wall contents. The method is named after its inventor, the Danish scientist Hans Christian Gram, between the period of 1853 to 1938, who developed the technique while working with Carol Friedlander in the marge of the city hospital in Berlin in 1884. Part 1 out of 3, preparing the slide. Step 1, part 1, prepare for the laboratory work.
Put on gloves to prevent contaminating the bacteria sample you will be testing. Disinfect workspace and you must check that the Bunsen burner and the microscope are functional before you paint.
Step 1, part 2. Add the sample to the slide.
Can use the Gramstein method to help identify bacteria present in a medical sample or bacteria culture ground in a petri dish. In order for the gram stain to be useful, add a thin layer of a sample on the stain. A sample under 24 hours old is recommended.
Step 1, part 3. Heat fix the smear.
It will fix the bacteria to the slide, so they are not as easily rinsed off during the stain. Quickly pass the slide 2 or 3 times. Throw a Bunsen burner.
Part 2 out of 3, reforming the Gramstein. Step 2, part 1, float the smear with a crystal violet.
First, use a bead to float the bacteria sample with several drops of crystal violet step. Second, wait 30 to 60 seconds. Crystal violet dissociate in aqueous solution into crystal violet positive and chloride negative ions. These ions penetrate through the cell wall and cell membranes of both gram-positive and gram-negative cells. The crystal violet-positive ion interacts with negatively charged components of bacterial cells to stain the cell's violet. Many laboratories use Hacker's crystal violet, which adds ammonium oxalate to prevent precipitation. By the way, sometimes it's called gentian violet.
Step 2, part 2. Rinse off the crystal violet gently.
Light the slide and use a wash bottle. Spread small stream of distilled or tap water over the top of the slide. The water should run down over the surface of the smear, but not be aimed directly at it. Do not rinse excessively, which might remove the stain from gram-positive bacteria.
Step 2, part 3. Flood the smear with iodine, then rinse.
Use a pipette to cover the smear with iodine. Let it sit at least
60 seconds, then rinse off with the same careful method.
Step 2, part 4. Add a decolorizer, then rinse quickly.
Mix of acetone and ethanol is typically used for this critical step, which must be timed carefully. Hold the slide at angle, then add the decolorizer until no more violet color is visible. This typically takes under 10 seconds, or even less time if the decolorizer contains higher concentration of acetone. Step immediately, or the decolorizer will remove the crystal violet stain from gram-positive and negative cell, and the stain will have to be repeated. Immediately, rinse off excess decolorizer.
Step 2, part 5. Float the smear with contrast stain, then rinse.
Contrast stain, typically safranin or flaxin, is used to add contrast between gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria. By staining decolorized gram-negative bacteria, bank coating, leave it on for at least 45 seconds, then rise up.
Part 3 out of 3, examining the result. Step 3, part 1. Identify gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria.
Examine the slide under light microscope. Gram-positive bacteria appear in purple color, where the negative bacteria appear in pink or red color. The sample is too thick, you maybe see false positive result. If the sample if the color is run too long, you maybe see false negative result. In either case, you must be returned the process to make sure the result is correct.
Step 3, part 2. Look up reference images.
You are not certain what bacteria is. Look through a collection of reference images, sorted by shape and result of the gram stain. You can find database online at the National Microbial Pathology.
Step 3, part 3. Identify gram-positive bacteria by shape.
Bacteria are further classified by their shape and their microscope, most commonly as cocci, spherical, or root, cylindrical. Here are few common gram-positive Kuiper stain.
Step 3, part 4. Identify gram-negative bacteria.
Gram-negative, pink stain. Bacteria are often classified into three groups. Cocci are spherical bacteria, roots are long, thin bacteria, and coccoid roots are somewhere in between. Gram-negative cocci are most commonly Neisseria spp. Gram-negative roots include E. coli, Enterobacter, Klebsiella, Citrobacter, and many others. Vibrio cholera can appear as ordinary roots or curved roots. Finally, gram-negative coccoid roots or Cocobacilli.
Step 3, part 5. Evaluate next results.
Some bacteria are difficult to stain due to the fragility of their cell walls. They may have mix of purple or pink stain in the same cell or among different cells in the same smear. Any bacteria assembled over one day old can have this problem, but some species are difficult to stain at any age.
Step 3, part 6. Dispose of materials.
Waste disposal procedure vary between laboratory and according to the material being used. Typically, the liquid in the staining tray is disposed in salt bottles as hazards with strip slide in a 10% bleach solution, then disposed of them in sharps container.
That was our short movie of gram stain that used in histology lab. Hopefully, you get the benefit and you enjoy our short movie about the gram stain. So, thanks for watching, and that's it.